I am a painter.
I think it's irrelevant for me to describe my career as opposed to someone else describing it.
I think of my art as my career, even though I have no income yet.
I don't think traditionally, because I feel that it is more accessible to the non-artist.
Whatever, it keeps me in the moment of creation, I guess.
So I'm working in installation now, as well as cutting some of my drawings.
Usually my day job involves me working in an art store.
Exist as a human being,
but my
I guess.
Real job in life is
my job.
To paint
I saved up
beautiful
a
pictures.
Bit of money for working and teaching for 6 years, so I'm living off what I've saved.
It'll only last once or twice if you're really careful with it. It'll last longer, but it's meant for you. And when you find that piece, that's it. To make one person happy.
I expect my technical ability as well as my main abilities to get some calls for artists, residencies, trying to get myself out in the public more so others know what I'm doing.
Do that part, well, not part time, but do that so that I can also work on my own artwork as well.
Henry Moore, Gustav Klimt, just along the same lines.
The only person that really comes to mind in terms of elegance is Wolfgang Leib.
I really like this guy, James Gurney, who made a series of books called Dinotopia back in the early 90s.
Arshel Gorky, who was an artist during that came over during the genocide, and I would say those two mainly. I also really like Glen Ligon's work, even though I don't work with text. I find his works very powerful at getting a message across in a way that I am not yet familiar with. With working with text.
I could sustain myself
if I can sell it, then yes, but economical sustenance isn't really
illustration type
important.
And I plan on trying to sustain myself more as I develop as an artist by getting into galleries, creating a fan base, and one day buying a big, giant, expensive printer and printing off high resolution prints of my work and sending it through the mail to people. My style is primarily figurative.
I would never really consider myself a writer or anything, since everything has always been such movement, so...
I work in a full palette with acrylic paint.
...of history and memories that
and for the work to be all around it, all around them. So it's more like you're walking into a three-dimensional drawing than seeing a sculpture.
So I think I have a style for what I'm doing now, but it'll change on my next project.
That makes sense.
I will want to do a PhD level of success within my social circle, but in terms of real art history, I don't think that I will see that kind of fame before I die. But there is a chance, possibly, that one of my children could attain this type of fame. I think often about the father of Robert De Niro, who was considered an abstract expressionist, and he did amazing paintings. And a lot of people within the art world know him, but no one outside of the art world knows him, but they know his son.
And
definition of art is.
I like to think of art as being practical sociology.
About something in a way that it hasn't been thought about before.
They usually have social implications or cultural resonance, sometimes political. Political things to say. They're things that people say without using words, because there is no words. There's more, I just don't know.
I think that culture is the only
culture
relative thing to change in the world.
To think outside,
because everything
culture
else is impermanent.
I think of culture very much like the planet Earth,
the
and
culture
trying to think outside of everything
is kind of
that is prescribed to you from day one is much like traveling in outer space. It's incredibly difficult, and you can't go very far usually before you get tired and have to return back to what you're used to. During an art show, usually I stand near my art and try not to get too drunk and
people looking at my work, I want them to look at the work. As soon as they know the artist is in the room,
presentation,
they react
that's
differently.
What I struggle
and
with.
A lot of the time, they want to look at the work, they just come straight over
to
you.
What
say,
I'm doing
oh, what's this about?
Without reading a book.
Don't do that, just look at the work. I would like to be in the room when people are seeing it, just so I can get a bit of feedback. Honest feedback though, so if I remain anonymous and just act as another viewer, then you can get a real honest answer from people.
I think that
I mean,
really
that
comes down to having
that
successful shows in your lifetime where a few fancy pants, fancy fartsy people respect your work for one reason or
the
other. There are a very small group of people that decide what is accepted and what is not, and it's all about when you meet those people and being ready for it.
I can stick with it long enough that people think I'm crazy enough that it's worth it, is what I think it ends up coming down to.
Yes, I think about being in
no,
arts.
Because that's a secondary portion of being an artist, I think.
Explore more professional means.
I'd rather focus on
it's important because
the solitary aspect.
It's really the only way to ensure potential family.
When you say you're an artist, they brush you off unless you're like a... They don't think much of you unless you're a lawyer or a doctor, etc. And that happens far too often. But other people are very interested. It's difficult to get a good conversation a lot of the time.
The only new technology I really use in terms of artwork is Photoshop. That's just strictly for printing my reference out. Then when I finish the piece for preparing it for the
internet.
I guess I don't really use technology with my art.
It doesn't.
Designs
except to like
doing
help accumulate information that I guess then goes into my art maybe.
Into technology, but I just use it as a tool to help with
technology. Just
some of
for the fun of it,
I've already been doing.
Always has to be sort of pragmatism, really.
As your existence as a human being, what is the importance of the evolution of your art?
What
is
the content and the purpose of that piece affect the overall critique or successfulness of
their
actions? There's content, horrible content in a piece, certainly a political piece. Should that be viewed subjectively or objectively? Can they be separate? Should they be separate?
Well, I think that actually any kind of political
if I had to
understand
100%, something like I can think about
perception, so I cannot think about the separation, how direct it is, and how successful
yeah,
it is.
Mostly,
well,
the artwork itself
is
a way to understand if I mean
and how much
which I sold.
They
were watercolor,
my point of view, the more it is direct, the more it's weak. If it's a little bit open to
And then when the viewers
more
coming back home, I'm still thinking about
cotton paper. I start stretching, and then I exhale something.
That's
something that's pretty much
a real essence. So it is an influence on nature, and it cannot be separated. But actually, too much clarity maybe
be perceived
as fixed. And so you're attempting to change your own opinion as a viewer, which is not totally nice from my point of view. It could be like a fascist point of view.